Hey there.
No way.
Yeah.
You got it?
I did.
Pikes peak.
Even after you said not to.
Dude, I just said there are better track tools from Ducati. And as good as this is still a heavy bike, man.
Still 4 kilos lighter than the regular Multistrada. Come, come, I'll show you how it is.
Damn. Holy cow. Damn, that livery looks good, man.
Yeah, inspired from the Desmosedici 21.
Hoppa, carbon fiber. I see carbon fiber.
Beak and the mudguard.
Sweet. 17 inch Marchesini forged rims.
That's where the weight saving comes from.
Damn. Even the brakes look different.
That's directly from the Panigale V4S.
Are you serious?
Yeah, the same brake pads as on the Panigale V4S.
Acura?
Slip on, not the full system.
What is this stock?
Yeah.
This comes with the bike?
Yeah.
Damn. What else is new?
Why don't you find out?
Oh boy! Huh? Wait, wait! Let me catch my breath.
And it's raining here so much. I can't even see a thing with these glasses on.
Oh man! What a machine! What a bike! And what an engine! I mean, more than anything, dude, it's just the engine. It's unbelievable. I genuinely think, as far as road is concerned, this engine is untouchable.
Yeah, I mean, in fact, if you remember our last Italy trip, I had an experience of the same engine on the Multi and on the Panigale. I loved it. I mean, that's the biggest reason why I considered this in the first place. It's a gem of an engine that a lot many people don't know about.
Yeah. I mean, this is the first Multi, right, which gets the race mode.
Man, I haven't had the guts to try it, but I hope you did, at least.
I mean, you saw how the weather was. Now it's nice and dry, but it was pouring in the morning and did not really feel that I can unleash the full fury of the engine, but I got a glimpse of it and that was man enough. I mean, the front still comes up in the third gear. And also the throttle sensitivity is, like, it's so much more direct.
Okay.
You feel a really nice connection with in terms of the map.
Talking about the throttle, what do you find with the ergonomics and the rest of the setup?
Even with the 17 inch wheel now, and as you said, the revised ergonomics, this is undoubtedly a lot sportier compared to the V4S. I like this handlebar, to be honest.
Okay.
My problem with the old or the Multi V4S was the fact that it was a little too wide.
Mm.
So especially taking U-turns and all was kind of a chore. This is much easier to handle and also to get the bike to turn. I mean, this is so agile. And again,
very, that goes to the wheel.
Yeah, very, very direct. Also, the front end feel is fantastic. Even in these wet conditions, you feel quite confident, you know exactly what's going on in the front. And then of course you have the Olin setup. Even this is, I think, the first Multi which gets the Olin setup.
So first Multi with the dedicated race mode, dedicated Olin suspension, semi-active obviously. Marquesney forged wheels.
So that's Skyhook, and that's what,
Marzocchi.
I
felt like it was too light to flick left and right through the traffic.
For sure. I think agility-wise, already I was blown with the V4S in terms of how quickly it changed direction, despite having a 19-inch front. This 100% is a lot more agile. But on the suspension front, you know, again, we could not really test it. Wasn't the best condition to really go all out and test it. But I'm a little bit surprised because I was expecting, as Ducati have gone, you know, all the way in, have given us a race mode, as you mentioned. I was expecting, even in terms of the suspension setup, that they gave the option like they have on the Panigale V4S, which is you have fixed damping and you have dynamic damping.
Okay.
Right now, this only has the dynamic damping and you can't really go inside and change the compression and the rebound individually. You can change the preload, but not the compression and rebound. And when I saw the suspension, I just assumed that this would have that too. You just have the hardest, the hard, the medium, the soft and the softest setting.
Okay.
And that is the damping for you. That's about it. And again, today the conditions were wet, where the maximum, the hardest we could go was medium.
Yeah. So do you think if it had a fixed suspension, that would have made a big difference?
I think on the road, this zero complaints. Yeah, this worked really well, really good traction, really good feedback. But I felt when you take this to the track, that is where, because even with the V4S, remember I was telling you, I tried riding with the dynamic damping and it was a horror show for me at least because it felt like the bike had a mind of its own.
Okay.
But then as soon as we went to fixed damping, the bike was transformed. It was so good in corners.
Interesting.
So this would be interesting to see how it does on the track, but I feel that's where I would miss it.
But I guess that's where it would vary for people who want to customize their suspension settings and explore the motorcycle. I don't know how many actually, I'm trying to learn. So half of the terms you say go over my head, but still, I'm still learning from your video. So in that sense, there is a lot more to explore in this bike.
I mean, think about it, right? Because even in terms of the braking setup, this is a full-blown braking setup straight from the V4S. That's really important. 330mm disc, you have sintered pads to the best of my knowledge. You have...
it's basically pulled off from the Panigale V4S, the exact brake pads.
So that's what I'm saying.
They've gone all the way, almost, almost. I say that because I see the tires were different.
Dude, I mean, that's the other thing. That's the other thing, right? When you have gone all the way in, yeah, you have made this the sportiest multi ever, the most powerful multi ever with that engine, right? And again, zero complaints there because the engine is fantastic. I don't know how anyone would want anything more than this because this thing, when it goes, yeah, you have to hold on for dear life. But then when you have this kind of equipment, I don't understand why they have gone for Rosso Force. I mean, I was thinking at least Rosso for Corsas because, I mean, realistically, with the Rosso Force, you cannot really put all this stopping power, all this power down, right? When I tried the Rosso Force on the Street Fighter V2, already the bike was moving so much. So I think that's just going to be exaggerated on this bike with such long travel suspension.
No, I get your point. I get your point about the tire spin, but do you think most regular bikers would need such high-end performance tires?
I mean, we are talking about the Pikes Peak, right? You have the normal V4S, which is already a mad bike. And now you yourself have gone ahead and gotten this. And from that perspective, I mean, that's my point. My point is they have done such insane stuff for an adventure bike. So why stop with the tires? And again, even there's no tire pressure monitoring system either, which I think is kind of essential, even from safety perspective, from a performance perspective, to make sure, you know, like the tires in the
especially
right range.
Especially when you have a race, dedicated race mode on track.
Exactly.
Without TPMS.
Exactly.
That's the first access we got. But do you think we need anything else besides these two? Better tires and a few more.
I think, yeah, TPMS and good tires, and I think we are pretty much sorted. But I have a question for you. You talk about tires, and these are not even Rosso Force.
Don't they look good, just like the rest of the bike?
No. Explain to me. Please, explain to me. You got this. We got into an argument. I told you not to go for it. You still went ahead. And your thing was, I just wanted one bike which can go on the highway, which will take me to the track, and which I can also ride on the track. And I said, okay, fine. Makes sense. And then you go ahead and put STRs on a Pikes Peak. Please explain.
That's the only bike in the world which has this.
I know. I want to know why.
The mountains in the background. That's where I'm heading next. Not these ones, obviously. I want to take the Pikes Peak to the highest motorable road in India, in the world. And that's happening next month. So I thought this would give me that extra sense of safety. Can't do that on the Rosso Force or Super Corsas, right? I know.
I'm still trying to make sense. then why not
the
V4S with the 19 inches? You know, which will give you a lot more.
But I'm someone who do track days too. I can't enjoy the track days on that. You might say, why not V4 Rally? But that's pushing too much on the touring front. This kind of fits my needs perfectly well. So if I want to tour, go to a track, finish the track session, come back home, change the tires to these, do a bit of off-road, not what I'm expecting at Umlingla.
With four rims. Off-road with forged rims, ladies and gentlemen.
Call me crazy.
I think it's in your name. But I have to say this, that this was surprisingly awesome in the wet today.
I saw you pulling some wheelies comfortably well.
Blame it on the engine. That wasn't my fault. But no, in terms of the grip as well from this, I think these cut actually help dissipate the water much better.
Yeah.
Because the road holding was surprisingly really, really good. But I don't know, man. You are one crazy mofo. For getting this, such a lovely bike. And even crazier to lend it to me, for which I'll be eternally grateful.
So I don't know
grateful.
Which is crazy, me doing all these modifications or giving it to you for experiencing the rain here in Thamini.
You know what? I think the perfect way for me to describe the situation is you remind me of this one video I'd seen a long time ago of this guy who bought a Ferrari so that he can off-road on it. And that was the video. He was doing proper slides and everything.
And
this is you.
And that's called a Puro Sangue now. So they're making that.
There you go. So baby, paving the path for that, but kudos, man. I love your passion to go all in to get such a lovely machine and then still not let it stop you from doing what you really want to do.
Well, always for the love of motorcycles.
Superb, dude. Let's head back.
Yeah, let's go. Oh, by the way, do you want to switch bikes?
Nah. I'll wait. I'm gonna enjoy this first.